Six of the 16 teams in the playoffs led by a new guy this year. And I know you're a fan, Dave Reed, of what Craig Berube has done there. Do you think he's done the best job of those six guys?
I think he has, considering that he didn't have the job at the start of the year. And all of a sudden it's like, okay, here's your team. We're really struggling. The reason you fire your coach is because your team is struggling. Craig, let's see what you can do. Craig Berube has done a fantastic job with this group. He's just allowed his players just to play their game. Craig Berube is a very, very tough player to play against. You did not want to meet him in the corners. He has got his team playing the way he played. Not dropping the gloves, but playing that in-your-face, high-tempo, push-the-play style, win all the one-on-one battles. They've got excellent scoring. Jordan Binnington, no question, has stepped in. And you could almost say he could be a Hart Trophy candidate the way he has turned this team around. Wow. The goals against has been fantastic. He has stepped up when needed. And that goes a long way for a coach. But the coaching of Craig Berube just allowing his team to go out and play their game with no pressure. And that's something you talk to these players, they're always saying how great it's been to have Craig Berube behind them on the bench. So for me, no question, Craig Berube in St. Louis is the guy not starting, that's the thing, not starting the season with this group and turning this whole group around. Best team probably in the National Hockey League since January 1.
That team needed accountability and a firmer voice, and Craig Berube bought both of those, and they responded. Good for them. But if I'm looking at those six teams of the new coaches, whose roster would I like the least? I think it might be Carolina heading into the season. If I look at, you know, some other pretty good teams, some pretty good players. So Rod Brind'Amour, who had to establish a culture, a winning atmosphere, and the storm surge and all that went with it, and getting his team, you will see the clips of them in the dressing room after games. There really seems to be a communal, collective, we're all in this together with our coach Rod Brind'Amour. Probably helps that he is recently retired and he's still in very good shape, and they can respect him on a player level, not just a coach level. And he's got that team playing very well. He got Mrazek and McElhinney to be good enough to get them to an almost 100 point season. So for me, Rod Brind'Amour, because of the group that he was forced to work with, which I think the forwards had some holes more so than the other teams, I think the job he's done there in Carolina, who'd been so long without seeing the playoffs, and making that team believe and trust each other, I gave him the best job of the six.
Six of the 16 teams in the playoffs led by a new guy this year. And I know you're a fan, Dave Reed, of what Craig Berube has done there. Do you think he's done the best job of those six guys?
I think he has, considering that he didn't have the job at the start of the year. And all of a sudden it's like, okay, here's your team. We're really struggling. The reason you fire your coach is because your team is struggling. Craig, let's see what you can do. Craig Berube has done a fantastic job with this group. He's just allowed his players just to play their game. Craig Berube is a very, very tough player to play against. You did not want to meet him in the corners. He has got his team playing the way he played. Not dropping the gloves, but playing that in-your-face, high-tempo, push-the-play style, win all the one-on-one battles. They've got excellent scoring. Jordan Binnington, no question, has stepped in. And you could almost say he could be a Hart Trophy candidate the way he has turned this team around. Yeah. The goals against has been fantastic. He has stepped up when needed. And that goes a long way for a coach. But the coaching of Craig Berube just allowing his team to go out and play their game with no pressure. And that's something you talk to these players, they're always saying how great it's been to have Craig Berube behind them on the bench. So for me, no question, Craig Berube in St. Louis is the guy not starting, that's the thing, not starting the season with this group and turning this whole group around. Best team probably in the National Hockey League since January 1.
That team needed accountability and a firmer voice, and Craig Berube bought both of those, and they responded. Good for them. But if I'm looking at those six teams of the new coaches, whose roster would I like the least? I think it might be Carolina heading into the season. If I look at, you know, some other pretty good teams, some pretty good players. So Rod Brind'Amour, who had to establish a culture, a winning atmosphere, and the storm surge and all that went with it, and getting his team, you will see the clips of them in the dressing room after games. There really seems to be a communal, collective, we're all in this together with our coach Rod Brind'Amour. Probably helps that he is recently retired and he's still in very good shape, and they can respect him on a player level, not just a coach level. And he's got that team playing very well. He got Mrazek and McElhinney to be good enough to get them to an almost 100 point season. So for me, Rod Brind'Amour, because of the group that he was forced to work with, which I think the forwards had some holes more so than the other teams, I think the job he's done there in Carolina, who'd been so long without seeing the playoffs, and making that team believe and trust each other, I gave him the best job of the six.